Hello everybody, this is Peter and welcome to chess. This is a game between Alexey Sorokin and Gladure Benjamin played in the second round of the Final4, and if there would have been a beauty prize, this game could easily have won it. Now this is a crazy position that arose from the Grünfeld defense out of all openings, and it was White's turn. White has a few options here, and he played a natural looking move knight to d6. Now instead the best move would have been the far from obvious rook takes c4. And after knight takes c4, which is a mistake, white would not take on c4, blundering the d1 rook, but rather play knight g5, threatening with a checkmate, and now also with bishop takes c4. Leaving white with a winning position. So instead black needs to react with queen c6, but after f3 white simply stabilizes. He can respond knight c4 with bishop c4. So it's not a real threat and white has a better position. But instead taking on c4, white played knight d6. And this is the first task of the video. If you wanna guess the best move, pause the video and think a little bit. Alright, so Benji reacted with bishop takes g2. Which is quite an amazing move. The point being that after king g2, black gives queen c6 check, takes back on d6. And after white moves king g1, let's say, takes on d6 and remains a pawn up after rook d6, queen g6, bishop c4, takes, king h8. So black is a pawn up here, but actually there is an even stronger move with rook g6 check. And now white cannot play king f1 because of checkmate on h1. And after bishop g4, now is the time to take back on d6, and after rook d6, queen d6, the difference is that now white cannot even take on c4, so black is just completely winning. But white saw this and he had a different move in mind. Now before we get to that move, I would like to point out also that bishop g4, which also looks tempting, fails to rook g6, bishop h5, and here there is a very important move, bishop f6. Intermediate move, attacking the queen. And after the queen moves away to queen f4, black has the very nice bishop e7 discovery, which is the only move again, very far from obvious. Knight f5, and now black needs to take on f5, queen f5, and now the point of the combination comes. Black can jump away with the bishop with a discover check. Bishop e4 check, bishop g6, bishop takes f5, bishop takes f5, and after knight c6, black is just simply better, being two pawns up, and his king is not in a real danger, because after king g7, bishop f6, he can defend on the black dark squares pretty effectively. Now, let's get back to what happened in the game. So white replied with an amazing resource, bishop d3, which must have shocked Benjamin quite a lot. And he had 5 minutes here to figure out how to defend. Well, the point being that of course the bishop, the queen is in a pin, so if black takes the bishop, then white simply captures on a4. And otherwise white is threatening with queen h7 checkmate, among other things. Black found here an amazing sequence of moves, amazing combination, and if you want to find the two, then pause the video and think about it. Alright, so after thinking about 3 minutes, Benji took on d3 anyways, sacrificing his queen. And now, played rook g6, creating a deadly battery on the g-file. With with the threat of the immediate threat of playing bishop c6 and just winning the queen. So now white has pretty much three moves. One of them is bishop g5, the other is queen h3 and queen h4, what happened in the game. So let's have a look at them one by one. After bishop g5, rook g5, the point being that now after queen h4, if the bishop moved away, then the rook is hanging. So the bishop sacrifices itself for winning a tempo. But this doesn't help white if white black plays now a precise move, which is bishop f6. In fact, this is the only winning move in the position. If black were to play rook g6 rather, then after rook takes d3, the fact that he can move, give a discovered check, doesn't win the game after king f1. Actually, white is surviving in this crazy position. But after bishop f6, rook d3, bishop f3 check, black is winning, because after queen g5, bishop g5 is just an easy victory with two pieces and a pawn against a rook, which is winning material advantage. And the point is that if white plays king f1, then there is a small combination here with rook g1 check discovery, king g1, and black takes on h4 anyways, with a winning position. And so bishop g5 doesn't work. Now after queen h3, interestingly enough, even though there are a lot of possible checks black could give, there is only one winning move, in fact, one winning sequence of moves. So if you want to find it, please pause the video again and think about the position. Alright, so if you found this move, congratulations, because this sequence is pretty difficult. Bishop h3 check is the only winning move. White needs to play king h1. And now bishop g4 is very important, threatening with bishop f3 checkmate. And then after king g1, black gives the precise bishop e2 check, taking away the f1 square from the king. And after king h1, gives mate with bishop f3. And so this is how queen h3 refuted. Now let's have a look at the game continuation, queen h4. There are a lot of possible checks, but bishop h3 and bishop f3 look most natural, and one of them is good and the other is not. Can you guess which one is the correct move? Well, bishop h3 is the mistake, because after bishop g5, it turns out that the fact that the bishop is hanging is crucial, and white is objectively winning, being a queen up, and white, when black not able to create serious enough threats. And so the correct move, therefore, is bishop f3 check. And here white could of course interpose with bishop g5, but after black simply taking on d6, black is up winning material, meaning he has, well, actually he has two pieces and two pawns for the queen, which is should be about equal, but the fact that the Viking is pretty weak, the diva rook is hanging, black is threatening to go back to rook g6 and then h6 and win another bishop, renders white's position hopeless. And so instead of just playing a completely hopeless position, white played king f1, which seems to get away with the king. And now comes the point of the combination that Benji had to calculate when he took on d3. Can you find the mate in 4 for black? Well, congratulations if you did. The solution is bishop e2 check, king e1, and now a very important bishop c3 check. The point being that black needs to lure away the rook from c1 and also block the c3 square. So were black to play rook g1 check, king d2, there would be no follow-up. Simply, white would just get away, and the bishop c3 could be taken with the king. However, after bishop c3 check, of course rook d2 runs into rook g1 checkmate. And if white takes on c3 with the rook, then after rook g1 check, king d2, rook takes d1, black gives an amazing mate in the center of the board, the white king blocked by its own pieces. And this is exactly how the game ended. So if you solve this combination, well, congratulations. And if you like this video, then make sure to subscribe and hit the notifications, and check out my stream on Twitch/AgileSloth. Well, thank you so much for watching. Catch up with you later. Bye bye.